Margaret May in Fairfield on EWTN's The Presence Radio in beautiful Maine. Hi, Margaret May.
Hi. I've got kind of a two-part proof of existence of God I wanted to get your thoughts on. The first being that the existence, or shall I say the proliferation of mathematics within nature, you know, like everything from how many leaves are on a particular branch and how they grow, and that you need all of this mathematical precision for anything to exist. And the second being that for any self-awareness to happen, you know, for any intelligence to happen, well, it's kind of like, you know, a spruce tree doesn't give birth to a pine tree. So if there is intelligence, then there must be, it must have been derived from somewhere in the very beginning.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, a couple of thoughts. In regard to the first comment about, you know, the mathematical conditions that are necessary for existence, I think possibly, Margaret, what this touches on is what is commonly referred to as the fine-tuning argument, where we see within the universe that there, well, there's different kinds of design arguments. The fine-tuning argument has to do with the initial conditions and constants present at the beginning of the universe, which are so improbable. Reason demands that there be a supercalculating intellect behind those initial conditions and constants that are necessary for the development of human life. But then you also have other sort of arguments or things about the universe based upon mathematical beauty, right? And mathematical conditions for existence, as you were pointing out, that doesn't have to do with the beginning of the universe, but complex things right now. And that would be an argument from design, which is referred to as sort of the intelligent design argument. So you can take complexity of things that are existing right now and reason back to the probability, the high probability of a supernatural intelligence beyond the physical universe. And then you could also take sort of these mathematical conditions that are necessary for human life at the beginning of the universe, and then reason to the high probability of a supercalculating intellect behind the beginning of time, space, matter itself. Mm-hmm. Now, Margaret, these are beautiful arguments that many find persuasive, and there are many fine minds in philosophy and in science that look to all of this fine-tuning and mathematical beauty within the universe and reason to a supercalculating intellect. But keep in mind, these sort of arguments are not metaphysical demonstrations of God's existence. They're probabilistic arguments, which are still legitimate and good in dialoguing with atheists. Mm-hmm. Now, concerning your second point, Margaret, real briefly, and that is to say, if we have intelligence, I think this is great because, you know, even the Catechism of the Catholic Church, Margaret, points out that we can come to know God's existence by way of the world and by way of the human person. So if we look at ourselves and we discover we are intelligent beings with a spiritual, rational soul, and once we arrive at how the soul is a spiritual soul, it's immaterial and is not dependent upon matter in an intrinsic way, then we can ask the question, well, whence did that soul come? Whence did that spiritual soul come? And through philosophical reasoning, we could arrive at an infinite spirit that is intelligent, directing and ordering our intelligence to its end, namely the truth. So I think these are two very good points, Margaret, to reflect upon and to bring up within discussions with atheists.
All right, thank you.
Okay. All right, thanks, Margaret May.